हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माई सेल्फ आहिर डीआर फ्रॉम आरबीएनबी कॉलेज श्रीरामपुर। टुडे आई डिलीवर अ लेक्चर ऑन रोटेशनल डायनामिक्स एज पर एचएससी बोर्ड सिलेबस। इन दिस वी स्टडी थ्योरम ऑफ पैरेलल एक्सिस। वी नो दैट इफ यू कंसीडर ए थिन यूनिफॉर्म रिंग of radius capital R and mass capital M. Capital M is the mass of thin uniform ring. Capital R is the radius of ring. And if this ring rotating about an axis passing through the point C, see the center of ring, then its a moment of inertia rotating about an axis passing through its center is given by IC, which is equal to mr square. We know the definition of moment of inertia. Moment of inertia of a rotating body is defined as sum of product of mass and square of distance from the axis of rotation. So we get moment of inertia of a thin uniform ring rotating about an axis passing through the point C. C is the center of circle. Now if we have to find out moment of inertia about an axis passing through the another point at say O, then we have to study how to find out the moment of inertia of a thin uniform ring rotating about an axis passing through the point O. For that purpose we use two theorems: theorem of parallel axis and theorem of perpendicular axis. Then with the help of these two theorems we can obtain or we can find out the moment of inertia of a thin uniform ring rotating about an axis passing through the point O. Similarly, instead of this ring we consider thin uniform disc, we consider thin uniform rod. With the help of these two theorem of parallel axis and theorem of perpendicular axis, we can find out corresponding moment of inertia. So for studying the theorem of parallel axis we have to consider a rigid body whose mass is capital M, and this rigid body consists of n number of small elements, each element having mass dm. So here we consider capital M is the total mass of a rigid body rotating about an axis passing through its center of mass. Then this rigid body consists of n number of small elements, each element having mass dm. So this is the mass of each element which is inside the rigid body. There is uniform distribution of mass because here this rigid body consists of n number of small elements and each element having small mass dm. Now if this body rotating about an axis passing through its center C, then its a moment of inertia is given by IC. So what is IC? IC is the moment of inertia of a rotating body. Rotating rigid body. About an axis passing through its center of mass. So remember that. What is IC? IC is simply moment of inertia of that rigid body rotating about an axis passing through the point C. This axis is a perpendicular to the plane of the figure. Always remember that. This axis which is perpendicular to the plane of the figure. Now, as this rigid body consists of n number of particles whose mass or n number of elements whose mass is dm, we consider out of that, we consider one small element which is situated at point P and its mass is given by dm. Now, if we consider another point, say O, through which this rigid body is rotating, then this axis also perpendicular to the plane of the figure and passing through the point O, its moment of inertia is given by IO. So we can say that IO is the moment of inertia of rotating body about any axis passing through point O. Now, this distance between O and C, or we can say that distance between these two parallel axes is equal to h. This distance is h between point O and point C. This is the distance between two parallel axes. So here we write OC is equal to h. Now from this diagram, according to this definition, here uniform distribution of mass, so its a moment of inertia passing through the point O is given by I O is equal to. Now for uniform distribution of mass, instead of summation we take integration. I O equal to integration. Then distance of this particle from the point O, because this rigid body rotating about an axis passing through the point O, so this distance is OP. This distance is OP. So square of this distance. So integration of OP square and mass of each element. So mass of each element is given by dm. So this is equation 1. Equation 1 gives us the moment of inertia of a rigid body rotating about an axis passing through the point O, which is equal to integration of OP square into mass of each element. Now, if this body is rotating about an axis passing through its center of mass, it is its center, then this distance is given by Cp square. This distance is given by Cp square. So we get Ic is equal to integration of square of distance is Cp square, and mass of each element is given by dm. This is equation 2. So from this figure we get Io equal to integration op square dm, and Ic is equal to integration Cp square dm. Now we draw a perpendicular on OC is produced. So we produce this distance OC in this direction, and we draw the perpendicular on that OC produced. That point is say D, and then there is formation of two right angle triangle. There is formation of two right angle triangle. Big right angle triangle is say ODP. We consider this big right angle triangle ODP. Now in this ODP, if you consider same diagram as like this one, this is point O, this is point D, and this is point P. Then there is formation of right angle triangle. This diagram ODP here. Now according to Pythagoras theorem, we get this OP square equal to OD square plus PD square. So we write according to Pythagoras theorem in triangle ODP, this OP square equal to OD square plus PD square. Now we know that in this diagram, this point is C. The distance OD equal to, the distance OD equal to OC plus CD. So we write OD is equal to OC plus CD. Then we write here OP square equal to OD square is equal to OC square, OC plus CD. So we write OC plus CD bracket square, and this remaining PD square as it is. We get OP square is equal to OC plus CD square plus PD square. Now we have to solve this square of this bracket. So square of this bracket is given by OC square plus twice OC CD plus this CD square and remaining PD square. Now we have to consider this small triangle here. Instead of this big triangle, we consider this small triangle. Triangle CDP. In this triangle CDP, in this diagram, this CDP, again use Pythagoras theorem. So according to Pythagoras theorem, we get PC square is equal to CD square plus PD square, means this square of this distance plus this distance, and that is equal to CP square. So this, instead of this PC square, we write CP square. So CP square is equal to CD square plus PD square. Now by substituting this value, CD square plus PD square, instead of this CD square plus PD square, we write directly CP square. So we write here intraangle CDP. We get CP square is equal to CP square is equal to CD square plus PD square. So instead of the both these two terms, we use only CP square. Then we get OP square equal to OP square is equal to OC square plus twice OC CD plus CP square plus CP square. Now this is equation 3. With the help of this equation 3, we get OP square. This OP square is equal to OC square plus twice OC CD plus CP square. But we know that what is OP square? We have to substitute this magnitude of OP square in equation 1. Then we get IO square is equal to IO is equal to integration of OP square dm. Now we have to substitute value of this OP square here. Then we get IO equal to integration of, instead of this OP square we write OC square plus twice OC CD plus CP square, bracket completed, into this DM. Now we write here IC directly. IC equal to integration of CP square DM. Then we erase all these terms. Now we have to separate the integration. On separating, we get IO equal to integration of OC square DM plus integration of twice OC CD into DM plus integration of CP square DM. Now see here, OC is equal to H. We have to substitute it here. Then we get IO is equal to integration of OC is equal to H, so square of the H square. So we get H square DM, integration of H square DM plus 2 is constant. So take out of the integration, twice of integration, OC is again H CD. Now here, if we show the distance CD, the distance CD is equal to small x. If we show this distance small CD is equal to small x, then we get H into X DM plus integration of CP square DM. Now here again H is constant, so take out of the integration. So we get IO is equal to H square in integration DM plus twice h into integration x dm plus integration of cp square dm. Now we know that this integration cp square dm is equal to ic. So we write here, instead of this integration cp square dm, we write directly ic. So we get io is equal to ic plus, we solve this term. Now this remaining, as you know that total mass of rigid body is capital M. Therefore, by integrating each small element, then we get total mass. So integration of dm is equal to capital M, because here dm is the mass of each element and capital M is the total mass of rigid body. So total mass of rigid body capital M is equal to integration of dm. So here integration of dm, so we write h square into capital M plus twice h into a integration x dm. Now see here, this point D is at a distance x from the center, and according to definition of center of mass of the body, integration of this x dm, that is also equal to 0. So by using definition of center of mass, we get integration x dm is equal to 0. When we substitute integration x dm is equal to 0, then this total term will become 0. Then finally we get io is equal to ic plus m h square. This is the final equation, say equation 3. Now here IO, what is IO? IO is the moment of inertia of a rigid body rotating about any axis passing through the point O. What is IC? IC is the moment of inertia of a rotating body about an axis passing through the point C. C is the center of the rigid body. So what is capital M? Capital M is the total mass of the rigid body. And what is h? H is the distance between two parallel axes. So with the help of this formula, IO is equal to IC plus MS square, we state the theorem of parallel axis. So only remember this formula, and with the help of this formula, write the statement of theorem of parallel axis. So concentrate on this formula. IO, the moment of inertia of a rigid body rotating about any axis, is equal to sum of moment of inertia of a rotating body about an axis passing through its center of mass and total mass of the and product of mass, total mass of the rigid body and square of distance between two parallel axes. This is the statement of theorem of the parallel axis. So for remembering the theorem of parallel axis, only remember this formula. With the help of this formula, we can write the statement of theorem of parallel axis. So again, concentrate on this formula. The moment of inertia of a rigid body rotating about an axis passing through the any axis, any point, is sum of the moment of inertia of a rotating body about an axis passing through its center of mass and product of total mass of the body and square of distance between two parallel axes. So in this way we study the theorem of parallel axis. Now we stop here.